to Soul Beginnings on 98.7 KISS FM. I'm Bob Slay. Hey, did you have a good weekend? Well, all you have to do now is just sit back and unwind. We're going to play Memories from the Past. We have a bunch of them for you, too, including Dr. King marching on Chicago, introducing our man Clint, Sam and Dave hit again, and make way for the very sexy Mrs. Peel. It all happened during the spring of 1966. Temptations with the first of four number one R&B hits in 1966. Get ready. The most popular R&B song of the spring of 1966 was a dance number from a three-member group out of Detroit. They called themselves The Capitals, and their song Cool Jerk spent 20 weeks on the R&B chart.
Now everybody, I want to hear you all. Ah, can you do it? and nervous when you're in your seat. Take off your shoes and pat your feet. We're doing a dance that can't be beat. We barefootin'. Went to a party the other night. Long tall Sally was out of sight. Threw away a wig and her house sneakers too. She was doing a dance without any shoes. She was barefootin'. She was barefootin'. She was barefootin'. She was barefootin'. Hey, little girl with your red dress on, I bet you can barefoot all night long. Take off your shoes and throw them away. Come back and get them another day. We barefootin'. We barefootin'. We barefootin'. We barefootin'. Everybody get barefooted. Take off your shoes. John Henry, he said to Sue, if I barefoot, would you barefoot too? Sue told John, I study stew. I was barefooting ever since I was two. It was barefooting. It was barefooting. It was barefooting. We barefooting. We barefooting.
Robert Parker with the only national hit of his career, Barefootin'. By the way, this song would enjoy a 17-week run on the R&B chart. And this is Soul Beginnings on KISS FM. The most popular love ballad of the spring of 1966 was written by Percy Sledge, who gave the songwriting credit to two members of his backup group, Cameron Lewis and Arthur Wright. The song became a huge national hit, reaching number one on both the R&B and the pop chart, When a Man Loves a Woman.
Put her down. When
this song. Smokey and the Miracles with Choosy Beggar, the B-side of Going to a Go-Go. And this is Soul Beginnings on KISS FM. You know, lots of movies were released in the spring of 1966. See if you remember some of these titles. The Chase with Marlon Brando, Jane Fonda, and Robert Redford. There was also Redford co-starring with Natalie Wood in Inside Daisy Clover. Sidney Poitier was busy trying to keep Anne Bancroft from committing suicide in The Slender Thread. And then there was Paul Newman, whose career had hit a dry spell. He saw box office success as a hip 1960s cool private eye named Lou Harper in the film Harper. The cast was full of stars, Robert Wagner, Shelley Winters, Janet Leigh, and Lauren Bacall.
Mrs. Sampson?
That's right.
Lou Harper. Albert Graves' telephone said you needed me for something.
Oh. Drink, Mr. Harper?
Not before lunch, thanks.
I thought you were a detective.
New type.
Oh. Albert Graves is one of our lawyers. It's on his recommendation I'm hiring you.
About time he threw some business my way.
Hmm?
I've known Albert since he was DA up here.
Oh, he said you were good at finding things. My husband's, you're sitting on my row. My husband's disappeared.
Tried missing persons?
Well, that might mean publicity. Ralph loathes publicity. Besides, he's got an abnormal fear of the police. I simply want you to find him and tell me which female he's with.
Any particular female?
I haven't the least notion. Ralph need never know about this. He'd be sure I was gathering material for divorce proceedings. Actually, I have no intention of divorcing him. I only intend to outlive him. I only want to see him in his grave. What a terrible thing to say.
People in love will say anything.
Harper would follow Hud and the Hustler in the string of popular movies for Paul Newman with the letter H in the title. There would be two more films in 1967 that would prove to be even more popular. And Harper finally helped Paul Newman shed the shadow of James Dean.
Oh, how happy you in more times than I can count. I have called you mine. You have stood by me in my darkest hour. In the world, how happy you have made me. Oh, how happy you have made me. Oh, how happy you somehow we've carried on in the world. How happy you have made me. Oh, how happy you have made me.
Girl, you brought joy to my dreams. All that was wrong, you have made it right. I love.
KISS FM.
Soul Beginnings.
Spread your wings for New Orleans. Kentucky, bluebird, fly away. And take a message to Michael. Message to Michael. He sings each night in song.
To Michael and the interracial group Shades of Blue with Oh How Happy on the Impact label. This new Soul Beginnings on 98.7 KISS FM. I'm Bob Slade, and the most popular jazz recording in the spring of 1966 was this song. You're listening to it right now. It's by Horace Silver. It's called Song for My Father. Let's listen. Brings back a lot of memories. 1966 was also a banner year for Motown Records. Just about everything Berry Gordy touched turned to gold, even if the songs sounded the same. Take these songs by the Isley Brothers and the Four Tops.
when they say she don't love me, she don't love me. They say my heart's in danger, cause you're leaving me for the love of a stranger.
Shake Me, Wake Me, and the Isley Brothers with This Old Heart of Mine, and this is Soul Beginnings on KISS FM. Some of the top news stories of the spring of 1966 included America's increased involvement in Vietnam. The war was now on television and on a nightly basis, too. In the spring, more troops were sent to Nam to help the war effort, and on April 26th, the United States admitted that American casualties for the first time exceeded those of the South Vietnamese. From March through June, there were anti-war rallies held across the country, and for the first time, draft card burning rallies were held. On June 11th, at a White House conference on civil rights, Corps National Director Floyd McKissick called on the United States to pull out of Vietnam. In politics, Ronald Reagan won the GOP primary for governor of California. His appeal was very simple. Reagan's appeal was to people who were worried about a mortgage, increased taxes, and that a black man would move next door.
Now you vote for me if you believe in yourself, if you believe in your right to control your own destiny, to run your own life.
Reagan would go on to win the election in November against incumbent Pat Brown.
I'm
But his version of the Rolling Stones' Satisfaction. And Junior Walker in the All-Stars, but I'm a road runner, baby. And this is Soul Beginnings on KISS FM. And back are the Temptations with the most popular of their four number one hits of 1966. This song would spend 8 weeks on top of the R&B chart. And on the pop chart, it would only go to 13. How do you figure that? Ain't too proud to be.
I know you want to leave me, but I refuse to let you go. If I have to beg, plead for your sympathy, I don't mind, cause you mean that much to me. Ain't too proud to beg, and you know it. Please don't leave me, girl.
Beginnings on 98.7 KISS FM. I'm Bob Slade. And in the spring of 1966, Muhammad Ali defeated Henry Cooper in London to retain his heavyweight title. And the world champion Los Angeles Dodgers started spring training without their star pitchers, Sandy Koufax and Don Drysdale. Both men staged a two-man holdout. They wanted more dough. And they were successful, too. The Dodgers gave in, coughed up $100,000 a man. How about that? A first, big league pitchers.
I want someone to hold me. I got to have. I want someone to caress. Someone to confess.
in the Vandellas with My Baby Loves Me and the Mad Lads with I Want Someone. This Soul Beginnings on Kiss FM. The James Bond influence could be seen on television and in the movies in the spring of 1966. In the movies, this sound had people laughing. Yeah, that was the sound of that special red phone from the White House to the head of Zowie, the special U.S. intelligence agency. Zowie employed the secret agent to defeat all secret agents, Derek Flint. That spring, James Coburn became a superstar as our man Flint.
I noticed that these men were wearing Battle of the Bulge ribbons.
There is no ribbon for the Battle of the Bulge.
Exactly. These men are imposters.
What, Gridley? This man's been with us. That's Gridley.
Sir, if you look around the eyes, you'll see some scars. On the bridge of the nose, plastic surgery.
You've cracked, Flint. All this high living, you've cracked.
And on television, in the midst of the Batman mania, comes a British import to the ABC television network. The show starred Patrick McNee as a bowler-wearing Mr. Steed and a very sexy Diana Rigg as his karate-chopping sidekick, Mrs. Peel.
Extraordinary crimes against the people and the state have to be avenged by agents extraordinary. Two such people are John Steed, top professional, and his partner, Emma Peel, talented amateur. Otherwise known as the Avengers.
Was a very popular show, especially with the young fellas out there who had an immediate crush on Miss Peel. Supremes with another big hit for them. Love is like an itching in my heart. This is Soul Beginnings on Kiss FM. In the spring of 1966, Dr. Martin Luther King brought his nonviolent civil rights movement from the South to the North. Target number one, the city of Chicago, Illinois. Housing was the major dispute. Strict segregation locked blacks into the slums, and they were not allowed to move into the suburbs where the whites dominated. The summer months would prove to be quite violent as Dr. King's campaign showed America racism was not limited to the South. Speaking of violence, James Meredith, who broke the color barrier at the University of Mississippi in 1962, staged a one-man march in his home state. He called it a march against fear. Meredith was shot in the back along U.S. Highway 51.
I'm hit in the leg, I know, in the head. Ain't nobody gonna get me in the car.
Here it comes right now, Jim.
Come on, man. Come on, Al. You got a mess?
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and 208 other civil rights protesters took up Meredith's march while he recovered. Weston with Helpless. Sad, this is Soul Beginnings on Kiss FM. And fresh off their success with You Don't Know Like I Know for Sam and Dave, songwriters Isaac Hayes and David Porter would go back into the studio to write the follow-up. And here's Ike.
Hold on, I'm coming. That was a big hit for Sam and Dave that David and I wrote and produced. Hold on, I'm coming. It started, we were in the studio trying to work up something. And, of course, Stax Records was an old movie theater. And what happened down in the center of the room up against the wall... was a heater, and in the wintertime you freeze to death, summertime you burn up. And we had the piano. Everybody would gather around the piano to work up a song. And so the restroom would it never changed locations. It was up in the corner of the room. So David, we were at the piano working on something. He said, David, hey man, I gotta go to the restroom, I'll be right back. I said, go ahead on. I'm down there playing keyboards, working. I stuck a groove, and it looked like it took David forever. Because I think he took a newspaper with him. So I said, Dave, come on, man, I struck a groove. Come on. He said, hold on, I'm coming. And by that time, he said, hey, that's it. He broke out of the bathroom, man, his pants down to his ankles, all tripping over himself. I got it. And we came down to the piano, man, and that's how, hold on, I'm coming. He said, hold on, I'm coming. That was the title. It was like a rescue song. You know, if you're in trouble and about to drown or whatever, you know, hold on, I'm coming. Have faith. That's what the song meant.
Show for this week. Special thanks to our own Isaac Hayes, our associate producer, as always, Bob Pickett. I'm Bob Slade. Keep a good thought. We'll see you next time as we remember the time on Soul Beginning.